I may not have thought this through very well since I have my paper that I can't see very well. So welcome, parents and families, grandparents. Thank you so much for being here tonight. We are here to celebrate our first trimester of learning. Tonight we're going to be highlighting the work of our artist partners, Jenny Hunt and Michael and Valerie Nelson. They've been working right alongside of our teachers to bring the learning to life. Tonight, in addition to selling raffle tickets and our giving tree, we just really want you to know that a lot of what you've contributed tonight goes to support our fifth graders for outdoor education. So, Valerie, you tell me when we're ready.
We are ready.
Okay.
Yes.
So, Camille Sanson was racked with pains when people addressed him as Saint Sains. He held the human race to blame because it could not pronounce his name. So he turned with metronome and fife to glorify other kinds of life. Be quiet, please, for here begins his salute to feathers, fur, and fins.
We may not have.
No, we do. Okay. So these, there'll be eight individual little pieces. Mr. Peck's and Mrs. Kenmunt's classes have been working on these. And to start each piece of music by Camille Saint-Saëns, there is a poem written by, I'll remember by the end of this, I'm sure, Ogden Nash. Our first one is Kangaroos. The kangaroo can jump incredible. He has to jump because he's edible. I could not eat a kangaroo, but many fine Australians do. Those with cookbooks as well as boomerangs prefer him in tasty kangaroo meringues. Aviary. While we have choral symphonies and 40-part motets, the birds have private arias and passionate duets, with songs to tell a rival off in no uncertain terms, and sometimes, on a rainy day, a requiem for worms. But while we worry over pitch or whether we're in time, the melody that they produce is perfectly sublime. For though they've never heard of tone or sharps or minor thirds, what takes a singer years to learn comes naturally to birds.
Oh.
Our next poem is called Fossils. At midnight in the museum hall, the fossils gathered for a ball. There were no drums or saxophones, but just the clatter of the bones. A rolling, rattling, carefree circus of mammoth polkas and mazurkas. Pterodactyls and brontosauruses sang ghostly prehistoric choruses. Amid the mastodonic wassail, I caught the eye of one small fossil. Cheer up, sad world, he said, and winked. It's kind of fun to be extinct. The swan. The swan is an enchanted bird, or so the legends tell, and certainly he plays the part exceptionally well. He proudly arches up his neck to show that he's in charge, as regal as the figurehead on any royal barge. But if you ask him if it's true what fairy tales portray, he merely gives a knowing look and slowly glides away.
Thank you.
a Nemesis Kenman's class is gathering. We want to congratulate the children who are here tonight. We have a number of missing performers, and the ones who are here are doing a wonderful job of covering for their friends. So yay for them.